Tastes like it sounds, don't it?
Exactly.
Officer, please.
I wasn't begging. I was just standing there.
Yeah, right. And people just walk them through their money at you.
Well, this is New York, Sergeant. People do weird things in New York.
Yeah, well, you're a little weird yourself. Sit down.
Sure.
Morning, Barn.
What do we got?
This is Sanford Whitney.
Mr. Whitney, I'm Captain Miller.
I know what you're thinking there, but for the grace of God, go I.
No. I found him begging out in front of Siegel's department store.
I was destitute, penniless.
Yeah, with $186 in his pocket.
Things are improving. Is that illegal?
Have a seat, Mr. Whitney. Just sit right down here. You can tell your story to Sergeant Ward Jehovitz. Sergeant Ward Jehovitz.
Yeah?
Did you really feel it was necessary to bring that man in?
That guy shouldn't be begging, Barney. He's in perfect health.
Would you?
If he was blind or deaf or all crippled up or something.
Well, Joe, it's not our job to make moral judgments.
He's taken away the business from the guys who really need it.
All right?
Look him. At least if he had a limp or something.
Harris late again, huh?
Yeah.
It's the second time this week.
Third, if you count. I'm not. But the information's there if you want it. Excuse me.
Your occupation?
Actually, I'm between careers right now.
Well, precinct, Dietrich.
Hold on a second.
Captain? Dispatch for you.
Captain Miller here.
What? By whom? Is he all right? Oh, thank God. Yeah, thanks. Yeah, thanks. Harris was shot at by another cop.
Oh, look at me.
Barney, I got this guy cold on a breaking and entering. Got my revolver out. And the next thing I hear is this jerk yelling at me, "Police, drop it." And? Well, so, I mean, I turn around to tell him who I am. That's when he start firing these bullets over my head.
What did you do?
Well, not being invincible, I dove.
They stopped firing.
Well, they got bored with that. Told me to throw my gun out, which I did. Broke the damn handle.
You told him who you
Pearl
were?
Pearl handle, $68 down the tubes.
You told him who you were?
Yeah, even while they were searching me. Barney, it was humiliating. Groping me all over like that. Hey, look at my pants, ruined.
Got me a collar.
No, he got away.
No, this collar.
Nothing, it's made like that.
Really?
Barney, those two morons in uniform almost cut me off in the damn prime of my life.
Just take it easy. I'll take care of it. I want to talk to them.
You will. They're coming right here from the hospital.
Hospital? They were hurt?
Well, I tried.
A
Well, you wouldn't happen to have an extra piece of that, would you?
No, that's it.
Oh. Well, then you go ahead. Just that I haven't eaten today, I thought it might help kill the hunger pains. Well, that's all right. I'll probably eat tomorrow. I feel lucky.
Here, take this.
Oh, not your last piece.
Go on, take it.
Bless you. Your generosity will be...
No, don't start trying to con me. That stuff doesn't work on me.
Of course not.
Hey, Harris. Hey, come on. No hard feelings, huh, Pally?
Barney, them.
Captain Miller?
Corman Frank Slater from the 1-8, Captain. Slater? My partner, Walt Dravick.
Dravick?
Yes, sir.
Here's our report, Captain, and we're real sorry about what happened.
What exactly did happen?
I think you'll find it all in there in the report.
I'd kind of like to hear it in your own words.
You're on.
Well, we got a call on a possible holdup.
That's right. The call came in, possible holdup.
And when we pulled up, we saw a man holding a gun on another man.
Correction, arresting a man.
Caucasian, 5'10", 165, slightly balding.
Ever occurred to either one of you that Sergeant Harris might be a police officer?
In those clothes?
I beg your pardon?
Hey, no offense, but you gotta admit you dress a little flashy for a detective.
Flashy? Are you defining this as flash?
Sure. We saw him and thought he was just another...
Dravick.
Hold that thought.
Shall we adjourn to my office, gentlemen?
We should get back on patrol, Captain.
This won't take very long, Slater.
Okay, Whitney, on your feet. I'm gonna take a picture, get some prints.
What for?
What for? You're going to jail.
Oh, you're joshing me.
Don't josh anybody.
Listen about that bail. I changed my mind. I want to make that phone call.
You had your chance.
Yeah, I thought it over. I want the call. Let me have the call, please. I mean, what difference does it make to you? One call. You got so many calls. You're
spitting on me.
I beg your pardon.
I make a telephone call.
Oh, thank you, Sergeant. Thank you.
Stop it.
Begging. It's the world's oldest profession.
I thought that was prostitution.
Well, somebody had to ask for it.
What my partner was trying to say, Captain, is that it gets a little rough out there, you know? Sometimes you can't tell the players without a scorecard.
Especially if he's black.
Ah, you're putting words in my mouth.
Fits like a glove!
Gentlemen.
You know, he punched me.
I'm sure it wasn't premeditated, Officer Dravick. Just a reflex action, right, Harry?
Okay.
Captain, we have to get back on patrol. Anything else I think you'll find in the report.
That's right. Everything we saw, heard, did...
Dravick.
Officer Dravick, how long have you been on the force?
Counting today?
Just counting today.
7.5 weeks, sir.
Oh, my God.
Captain, I think you get the picture now. The kid was a little overzealous, that's all. He shot without thinking.
Well, according to this report, you got off a couple of rounds yourself.
Well, I got caught up in the moment.
Yeah.
I'll explain everything when you get here, Bruce. No, nothing happened at the office. Just get over here with the money.
Leave the children with the maid and get out of here. All right? Goodbye.
Thank you.
Did you say the maid?
Maid? Yes.
You got a maid just from begging?
What difference does it make what a man does? As long as he does it well.
Hey,
Okay, you can go now, but stay available.
All right, thanks, Captain. We'll do that. Come on, Walt.
Oh, hold it, Walt. Barney, that's it? That's all that happens?
Well, for the time being, yes.
Barney. This guy here, Whitney?
No, Walt.
He makes more money than we do.
Whoa, Joe! I said, hold it, Walt. Barney, these two guys are gonna just walk out of here?
Well, no, now we get on with the official proceedings.
Such as,
formal investigation by the borough commander.
Borough commander.
Hearing by the gun review board. Possibly internal affairs.
And what happens to them?
Well, that's hard to say.
Maybe a suspension, maybe a fine, maybe...
Maybe.
Maybe nothing.
Dietrich.
He asked.
I appreciate that, Dietrich. Now that I know, I can decide on a course of action.
It's already in progress, Harris. We go by the book.
You mean the book written by the man?
Morning, everybody.
What do you want, Leonard?
Nothing. Mail, general rounds. Not being assigned up here, I have no way of knowing when I come in at inopportune moments. Shall I leave, sir?
No, just stay right there.
Right. Hey, as long as I understand the rules, now maybe I can try and play the game.
Harris, you're not thinking clearly now.
Oh, that happens every time I'm shot at, Barney.
Hey, look, if you're really going to make an issue out of this...
Issue? You know... Issue? You cream-colored Harris!
Harris, for lunch.
Thank you! I'm leaving. Cover me.
In here, ma'am.
Is this where he is?
Yes, ma'am. Cat Miller, a Mrs. Ruth Whitney.
Ma'am?
Claims we're holding her husband.
Ruth!
Sanford? What happened to you?
What have you done to him? What is going on here? Why is my husband dressed like a bum?
Question, Mrs. Whitney. Mr. Whitney?
Ruth, I've got a confession to make. I'm not a stock analyst anymore, and I haven't been for 3 years.
What?
I've been working as a solicitor.
A lawyer?
A beggar.
Beggar?
Don't say it like that!
How else would you say it?
A beggar. Simple. Nice, soft. A lawyer? A doctor? A beggar? What's so tough?
May I speak to him in private for a moment, please?
Certainly, ma'am. Pleasure.
We'll let you in your cage for a few minutes, Mrs. Whitney. Hey, Harris.
Well, Joe?
Harris.
Dietrich?
Harris?
Barney.
Hi.
Hi. Excuse me.
Yes.
Well,
gentlemen, we have a lot of work to do. We have.
How was lunch?
Adequate, thank you.
Feel any better?
There isn't anything to feel any better about, is there?
Well, at least you've cooled down a little.
I didn't punch anybody else, if that's what you meant.
That's what I mean.
I didn't want to tell you I got fired until I'd gotten another job.
But begging, Sanford?
Necessity is the mother of invention, Ruth. I sold that lot we had upstate. I used that money for a year, but then it ran out. And then one day, I was about to get on a train to come home. I realized I didn't have the price of the ticket.
So I had to borrow it from a stranger on Wall Street. And you know what? It was easy. He loved giving it to me, Ruth. It made him feel good, took away his guilt. I mean, all day long, wheeling and dealing, crushing business competitors, cheating on his income tax, maybe even stepping out on his wife a night or two. And at the end of the day, suddenly, an opportunity to do something for somebody. People are like that, Ruth. They need me, don't you see that? I'm their atonement. I'm making a contribution, for God's sake.
Barney.
Yeah?
You got a minute?
Sure, come on in.
What's the problem?
Well, it's Harris.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say to the guy. He acts like we're some kind of poison sumac or something.
Well, Woj, I think we're just going to have to learn to be a little more understanding. I appreciate the fact that, that Harris has special problems.
Like what?
Like, he's black.
Well, I knew that.
Well, I thought those differences weren't important. Well, they're not. But they are.
Thanks for clearing that up.
Woj, it's like a Polish joke.
What?
Well, if somebody came up to you and said, how many poles does it take to make popcorn? You wouldn't appreciate that, would you?
No.
And I can understand it. But I could never feel what you're feeling. Because I'm not Polish.
Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
I can understand it, but that's as close as I can get.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. Thanks, Martin. How many does it take?
George, I don't want to get into that. I don't know.
Hey. It's all right. No, I'm just curious.
Five.
Five?
Look, I said I didn't want to, you know. One to hold a pan and four to shake the stove.
That's stupid.
Well, of course it is.
All you gotta do is move the pan around on the fire a little bit.
Close call today, huh? I know what it's like, being a minority, I mean. Anything under 5'10", 5'11", people dump all over you. I know how you feel.
Captain, I've paid the bail downstairs. May we leave?
Roger? I don't know what you're so upset about. I really don't.
Let's just say I'm disillusioned, Sanford.
But you're well-dressed.
Okay. I'm just gonna step out of there and go over to the desk.
You want me to go back on Wall Street? Well, do you know what's going on in the market right now? Do you?
I don't care, Mr. Whitney. Follow me.
You don't care. Down 40 points in 3 days. The dollar's in the toilet, Ruth. In the toilet.
Really?
Doesn't anybody around here read newspapers, buy Newsweek, listen to Paul Harvey? Are you married?
Yes.
Is your wife used to the finer things in life come from a rich family?
Greedy, selfish, frivolous, a woman of no substance who would allow a man to sink into the depths of degradation.
I have not degraded myself. Excuse me. I did what was necessary to give my family sustenance when it was needed.
I appreciate what you did, Sanford. I appreciate the thought. There must have been another way.
Sue me. I couldn't think of one.
Here you go. You're all set.
Please. Can we go now, Sanford?
Okay. Okay. Back to the rat race. 9 to 5, sniveling around, living in fear, kissing behind.
Talk about degradation.
Harris, I really think that was a lousy thing that happened today. And I just want you to know that.
Hey, I'm trying to talk to you.
I don't think there's anything to say.
Well, you damn well better think there's something to say if we're going to be working together around here.
Just take it easy.
He's right. There are some things that are just going to have to be said. Now, I'm sorry if you're not in the mood. But if we're going to function as a squad, there are a few things that we're just going to have to get straight around here. Levitt, stay where you are. You're part of this.
Yes, sir. I understand how we feel, sir.
Somehow, we're going to have to figure some way of restoring our lines of communication here.
Okay, well, all I want to ask is, how come after 4 years of working together, something happens on the outside and it gets turned against us?
Look, man, you don't understand, so why bother?
Well, maybe I can understand. I never thought of you as black.
See?
Well, I thought of you as a man. I thought of you as a friend, as a partner. If you want me to think of you as black, okay, fine, whatever you want. But just let me know, so I don't go offending you when I don't even know I'm offending you.
May I say something?
Dietrich.
Semantics is my life.
So what?
What I'm saying is, I think Harris understands the intent. Maybe we're just not saying it properly.
Possibly. I just never thought we'd have to say it at all.
It's been a bad day.
There may be more.
There will be more.
We can handle it.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You see? Communication.
Nice talking to you.
My pleasure.
You know, it only takes two to make a dialogue.
Right.
Five to make popcorn. That's what Barney said.
Barney, I got this guy cold on a breaking and entering. Got my revolver out. And the next thing I hear is this jerk yelling at me, "Police, drop it." And? Well, so, I mean, I turn around to tell him who I am. That's when they start firing these bullets over my head.
What did you do?
Well, Not being invincible, I dove.
They stopped firing.
Well, they got bored with that. Told me to throw my gun out, which I did. Broke the damn handle.
You told them who you
Pearl
were.
Pearl handle, $68 down the tubes.
Told them who you were.
Yeah, even while they were searching me. Barney, it was humiliating. Groping me all over like that. Hey, look at my pants, ruined.
Got me a collar.
No, he got away.
No, this collar.
Nothing, it's made like that.
Really?
Barney, those two morons in uniform almost cut me off in the damn prime of my life.
Just take it easy, I'll take care of it. I want to talk to them.
You will. They're coming right here from the hospital.
Hospital? They were hurt?
Well, I tried.
Oh, you wouldn't happen to have an extra piece of that, would you?
No, that's it.
Oh. Well, then you go ahead. Just that I haven't eaten today, I thought it might help kill the hunger pains. Oh, that's all right. I'll probably eat tomorrow. I feel lucky.
Here, take this.
Oh, not your last piece.
Go on. Go on, take it.
Bless you. Your generosity will be...
No, don't start trying to con me. That stuff doesn't work on me.
Of course not.
Hey, Harris. Hey, come on. No hard feelings, huh, Pally?
Barney, them.
Captain Miller?
Drummond Frank Slater from the 1-8, Captain. Slater? My partner, Walt Dravick.
Dravick?
Yes, sir.
Here's our report, Captain, and we're real sorry about what happened.
What exactly did happen?
Well, I think you'll find it all in there in the report.
I'd kind of like to hear it in your own words.
You're on.
Well, we got a call on a possible holdup.
That's right. The call came in, possible holdup.
And when we pulled up, we saw a man holding a gun on another man.
Correction, arresting a man.
Caucasian, 5'10", 165, slightly balding.
Ever occurred to either one of you that Sergeant Harris might be a police officer?
In those clothes?
I beg your pardon?
Hey, no offense. But you gotta admit, you dress a little flashy for a detective.
Flashy? Are you defining this as flash?
So we saw him and thought he was just another...
Dravick.
Hold that thought.
Shall we adjourn to my office, gentlemen?
We should get back on patrol,
this won't
Captain.
Won't take very long, Slater.
Okay, Whitney, on your feet. I'm gonna take a picture, get some prints.
What for?
Before you're going to jail.
Oh, you're joshing me.
Don't josh anybody.
Listen about that bail. I changed my mind. I want to make that phone call.
You had your chance.
Yeah, I thought it over. I want the call. Let me have the call, please. I mean, what difference does it make to you? One call. You got so many calls. You're
spitting on me.
I beg your pardon.
I'll make a telephone call.
Oh, thank you, Sergeant. Thank you.
Stop it.
Begging. It's the world's oldest profession.
I thought that was prostitution.
A solicitor.
A lawyer?
A beggar.
Beggar?
Don't say it like that.
How else would you say it?
A beggar. Simple. Nice. Soft. A lawyer. A doctor. A beggar. What's so tough?
May I speak to him in private for a moment, please?
Certainly, Roger.
We'll let you in the cage for a few minutes, Mrs. Whitney.
Harris.
Well, Joe.
Harris.
Dietrich.
Harris.
Barney.
Barney.
Hi.
Hi. Excuse me.
Yes.
Well,
gentlemen, we have a lot of work to do. We have.
How was lunch?
Adequate, thank you.
Feel any better?
There isn't anything to feel any better about, is there?
At least you cooled down a little.
I didn't punch anybody else, if that's what you meant.
That's what I mean. I didn't want to tell you I got fired until I'd gotten another job.
But begging, Sanford?
Necessity is the mother of invention, Ruth. I sold that lot we had upstate. I used that money for a year, but then it ran out. And then one day, I was about to get on a train to come home. I realized I didn't have the price of the ticket. So I had to borrow it from a stranger on Wall Street. And you know what? It was easy. He loved giving it to me, Ruth. It made him feel good, took away his guilt. I mean, all day long, wheeling and dealing, crushing business competitors, cheating on his income tax, maybe even stepping out on his wife a night or two. And at the end of the day, suddenly, an opportunity to do something for somebody. People are like that, Ruth. They need me, don't you see that? And they're atonement. I'm making a contribution, for God's sake.
Barn.
Yeah?
You got a minute?
Sure, come on in.
What's the problem?
Well, it's Harris.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to say to the guy. He acts like we're some kind of poison sumac or something.
Well, Boj, I think we're just going to have to learn to be a little more understanding. I appreciate the fact that, that Harris has special problems.
Like what?
Like, he's black.
I knew that. Well, I thought those differences weren't important.
Well, they're not. But they are.
Thanks for clearing that up.
Woj, it's like a Polish joke.
What?
Well, if somebody came up to you and said, how many poles does it take to make popcorn? You wouldn't appreciate that, would you?
No.
And I can understand that. But I could never feel what you're feeling. Because I'm not Polish.
Yeah.
Good.
Morning, Captain.
Morning, Dietrich. It's kind of quiet around here this morning, huh?
Bathroom's the same way.
Is that fresh coffee?
Nixon caught for a couple of days.
So?
So, I took the liberty of brewing a batch.
How very thoughtful of you.
Here you go, with my sincere wishes for your continued good health.
Why, thank you. It's an interesting taste. Sort of like, wood.
Close, it's barley.
Barley?
Yeah, barley, chicory, molasses. Natural coffee substitute. Contains no caffeine and no acids, thus eliminating all detrimental side effects. Tastes like it sounds, don't it?
Exactly.
Yeah, officer, please.
I wasn't begging. I was just standing there.
Yeah, right. And people just walk them through their money at you.
Well, this is New York, Sergeant. People do weird things in New York.
Yeah, well, you're a little weird yourself. Sit down.
Good job.
Morning, Barn.
What do we got?
This is Sanford Whitney.
Mr. Whitney, I'm Captain Miller.
I know what you're thinking there, but for the grace of God, go I.
No.
I found him begging out in front of Siegel's department store.
I was destitute, penniless.
Yeah, with $186 in his pocket.
Things are improving. Is that illegal?
Just have a seat, Mr. Whitney. Just sit right down here. You can tell your story to Sergeant Ward Jehowitz. Sergeant Ward Jehowitz.
Yeah?
Did you really feel it was necessary to bring that man in?
That guy shouldn't be begging, Barney. He's in perfect health.
Would you?
If he was blind or deaf or all crippled up or something.
Well, Joe, it's not our job to make moral judgments.
He's taken away the business from the guys who really need it.
All right?
Look him. At least if he had a limp or something.
Harris late again, huh?
Yeah.
It's the second time this week.
Third, if you count. I'm not. But the information's there if you want it. Excuse me.
Your occupation?
Actually, I'm between careers right now.
Well, precinct, Dietrich. Hold on a second. Captain? Dispatch for you.
Captain Miller here.
What? By whom? Is he all right?
Oh, thank God. Thanks. Yeah, thanks. Harris was shot at by another cop.
Oh, look at me.
Does that make sense?
I can understand it, but that's as close as I can get.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. Thanks, Martin. How many does it take?
No, Joe, I don't want to get into that. I don't.
Oh, hey. It's all right. No, I'm just curious. Five?
Look, I said I didn't want to, you know. One to hold the pan and four to shake the stove.
That's stupid.
Well, of course it is.
All you gotta do is move the pan around on the fire a little bit.
Close call today, huh? I know what it's like, being a minority, I mean. Anything under 5'10, 5'11, people dump all over you. I know how you feel.
Captain, I've paid the bail downstairs. May we leave?
Roger. I don't know what you're so upset about. I really don't.
Let's just say I'm disillusioned, Sanford.
But you're well-dressed.
Okay. I'm just gonna step out of there and go over to the desk.
You want me to go back on Wall Street? I mean, do you know what's going on in the market right now? Do you?
I don't care, Mr. Whitney.
Follow me.
You don't care. Down 40 points in 3 days. The dollar's in the toilet, Ruth. In the toilet.
Really?
Doesn't anybody around here read newspapers, buy Newsweek, listen to Paul Harvey? Are you married?
Yes.
Is your wife used to the finer things in life come from a rich family?
Greedy, selfish, frivolous. A woman of no substance who would allow a man to sink into the depths of degradation.
I have not degraded myself.
Excuse me.
I did what was necessary to give my family sustenance when it was needed.
I appreciate what you did, Sanford. I appreciate the thought. There must have been another way.
Sue me. I couldn't think of one.
Here you go. You're all set.
Please. Can we go now, Sanford?
Okay. Okay. Back to the rat race. 9 to 5, sniveling around, living in fear, kissing behind.
Talk about degradation.
Harris, I really think that was a lousy thing that happened today. And I just want you to know that.
Hey, I'm trying to talk to you.
I don't think there's anything to say.
Well, you damn well better think there's something to say if we're gonna be working together around here.
Just take it easy. He's right. There are some things that are just gonna have to be said. Now, I'm sorry if you're not in the mood. But if we're going to function as a squad, there are a few things that we're just going to have to get straight around here. Levitt, stay where you are. You're part of this.
Yes, sir. I understand how we feel, sir.
Somehow, we're going to have to figure some way of restoring our lines of communication here.
Okay, well, all I want to ask is, how come after 4 years of working together, something happens on the outside and it gets turned against us?
Look, man, you don't understand, so why bother?
Well, maybe I can understand. I never thought of you as black.
See?
Well, I thought of you as a...
Well, somebody had to ask for it.
What my partner was trying to say, Captain, is that it gets a little rough out there, you know? Sometimes you can't tell the players without a scorecard.
Especially if he's black.
Now, you're putting words in my mouth.
Bitch like a glove!
Gentlemen, you know, he punched me. I'm sure it wasn't premeditated, Officer Dravik. Just a reflex action, right, Harris?
Okay.
Captain, we have to get back on patrol. Anything else I think you'll find in the report?
That's right. Everything we saw, heard, did...
Dravik.
Officer Dravik, how long have you been on the force?
Counting today?
Just counting today.
7.5 weeks, sir.
Oh, my God.
Captain, I think you get the picture now. The kid was a little overzealous, that's all. He shot without thinking.
Well, according to this report, you got off a couple of rounds yourself.
Well, I got caught up in the moment.
Yeah.
I'll explain everything when you get here, Ruth. No, no, nothing happened at the office. Just get over here with the money.
Leave the children with the maid and get out of here. All right? Goodbye.
Thank you.
Did you say the maid?
Maid? Yes.
You got a maid just from Beggy?
What difference does it make what a man does? As long as he does it well.
Hey, you can go now, but stay available.
All right, thanks, Captain. We'll do that. Come on, Walt.
Hold it, Walt. Barney, that's it? That's all that happens?
Well, for the time being, yes.
Barn. This guy here, Whitney?
No, Walt.
He makes more money than we do.
Whoa, Joe!
I said, hold it, Walt. Barney, these two guys are gonna just walk out of here?
Well, no, now we
get on with the official proceedings.
Such as?
Such as,
Formal investigation by the borough commander.
Borough commander.
Hearing by the gun review board. Possibly internal affairs.
And what happens to them?
Well, that's hard to say.
Maybe a suspension, maybe a fine, maybe...
Maybe?
Maybe nothing.
Dietrich.
He asked.
I appreciate that, Dietrich. Now that I know, I can decide on a course of action.
It's already in progress, Harris. We go by the book.
You mean the book written by the man?
Morning, everybody.
What do you want, Levin?
Nothing. Mail, general rounds. Not being assigned up here, I have no way of knowing when I come in at inopportune moments. Shall I leave, sir?
No, just stay right there. Right.
Hey, as long as I understand the rules, now maybe I can try and play the game.
Harris, you're not thinking clearly now.
Oh, that happens every time I'm shot at, Barney.
Hey, look, if you're really going to make an issue out of this...
Issue?
You know...
Issue? You cream-colored Harris!
Harris, go to lunch.
Thank you!
I'm leaving. Cover me.
In here, ma'am.
Is this where he is?
Yes, ma'am. Cap Miller, I'm Mrs. Ruth Whitney.
Ma'am?
Claims we're holding her husband.
Ruth!
Sanford? What happened to you?
What have you done to him? What is going on here? Why is my husband dressed like a bum?
Good question, Mrs. Whitney. Mr. Whitney?
Ruth, I've got a confession to make. I'm not a stock analyst anymore, and I haven't been for 3 years.
What?
I've been working as a...
Good.
Morning, Captain.
Morning, Dietrich. It's kind of quiet around here this morning, huh?
Bathroom's the same way.
Is that fresh coffee?
Nick's in court for a couple of days.
So?
So... I took the liberty of brewing a batch.
How very thoughtful of you.
Here you go, with my sincere wishes for your continued good health.
Why, thank you. It's an interesting taste. Sort of like, wood.
Close, it's barley.
Barley?
Yeah, barley, chicory, molasses. Natural coffee substitute contains no caffeine and no acids, thus eliminating all detrimental side effects. Tastes like it sounds, don't it?
Exactly.
Yeah, officer, please.
I wasn't begging. I was just standing there.
Yeah, right. And people just walk them through their money at you.
Well, this is New York, Sergeant. People do weird things in New York.
Yeah, well, you're a little weird yourself.
Sit down.
Sure.
Morning, Barn.
What do we got?
This is Sanford Whitney.
Mr. Whitney, I'm Captain Miller.
I know what you're thinking there, but for the grace of God, go I.
No. Found him begging out in front of Siegel's department store.
I was destitute. Penniless.
Yeah, with $186 in his pocket.
Things are improving. Is that illegal?
Just have a seat, Mr. Whitney. Just sit right down here. You can tell your story to Sergeant Ward Jehovitz. Sergeant Ward Jehovitz.
Yeah? Did you really feel it was necessary to bring that man in?
That guy shouldn't be begging, Barney. He's in perfect health.
Would you?
If he was blind or deaf or all crippled up or something.
Well, Joe, it's not our job to make moral judgments.
He's taken away the business from the guys who really need it.
Right?
Look him. At least if he had a limp or something.
Harris late again, huh?
Yeah.
It's the second time this week.
Third, if you count. I'm not. But the information's there if you want it. Excuse me.
Your occupation?
Actually, I'm between careers right now. For Precinct Dietrich. Hold on a second.
Captain?
Dispatch for you.
Captain Miller here.
What? By whom?
Is he all right? Oh, thank God. Yeah, thanks. Harris was shot at by another cop.
Oh, look at me.
Barney, I got this guy cold on a breaking and entering. Got my revolver out. And the next thing I hear is this jerk yelling at me, "Police, drop it." And? Well, so, I mean, I turn around to tell him who I am. That's when they start firing these bullets over my head.
What did you do?
Well, not being invincible, I dove.
They stopped firing.
Well, they got bored with that. Told me to throw my gun out, which I did. Broke the damn handle.
You told him who you
Pearl
were?
Pearl handle, $68 down the tubes.
Told him who you were?
Yeah, even while they were searching me. Barney, it was humiliating. Groping me all over like that. Hey, look at my pants, ruined.
Got me a collar.
No, he got away.
No, this collar.
Nothing, it's made like that.
Really?
Barney, those two morons in uniform almost cut me off in the damn prime of my life.
Just take it easy. I'll take care of it. I want to talk to them.
You will. They're coming right here from the hospital.
Hospital? They were hurt?
Well, I tried.
Oh, you wouldn't happen to have an extra piece of that, would you?
No, that's it.
Oh. Well, then you go ahead. Just that I haven't eaten today, I thought it might help kill the hunger pains. Well, that's all right. I'll probably eat tomorrow. I feel lucky.
Here, take this.
Oh, not your last piece.
Go on, take it.
Bless you. Your generosity will be...
No, don't start trying to con me. That stuff doesn't work on me.
Of course not.
Hey, Harris. Hey, come on. No hard feelings, huh, Pally?
Barney, them.
Captain Miller?
Corman Frank Slater from the 1-8, Captain.
Slater?
My partner, Walt Dravik.
Dravik?
Yes, sir.
Here's our report, Captain, and we're real sorry about what happened.
What exactly did happen?
I think you'll find it all in there in the report.
I'd kind of like to hear it in your own words.
You're on.
Well, we got a call on a possible holdup.
That's right. The call came in, possible holdup.
And when we pulled up...
We saw a man holding a gun on another man.
Correction, arresting a man.
Caucasian, 5'10", 165, slightly balding.
Ever occurred to either one of you that Sergeant Harris might be a police officer?
In those clothes?
I beg your pardon?
Hey, no offense, but you gotta admit you dress a little flashy for a detective.
Flashy? Are you defining this as flash?
Sir, we saw him and thought he was just another...
Traffic.
Hold that thought.
Shall we adjourn to my office, gentlemen?
We should get back on patrol,
this won't
Captain.
Won't take very long, Slater.
Okay, Whitney, on your feet. I'm gonna take a picture, get some prints.
What for?
What for? You're going to jail.
Oh, you're joshing me.
Don't josh anybody.
Listen about that bail. I changed my mind. I want to make that phone call.
You had your chance.
Yeah, I thought it over. I want the call. Let me have the call, please. I mean, what difference does it make to you? One call. You've got so many calls. You're
spitting on me.
I beg your pardon.
I make a telephone call.
Oh, thank you, Sergeant. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Stop it.
Begging. It's the world's oldest profession.
I thought that was prostitution.
Well, somebody had to ask for it.
What my partner was trying to say, Captain, is that it gets a little rough out there, you know? Sometimes you can't tell the players without a scorecard.
Especially if he's black.
Ah, you're putting words in my mouth.
Fits like a glove!
Gentlemen. You know, he punched me. I'm sure it wasn't premeditated, Officer Dravik. Just a reflex action, right, Harris?
Okay.
Captain, we have to get back on patrol. Anything else I think you'll find in the report?
That's right. Everything we saw, heard, did...
Dravik.
Officer Dravik, how long have you been on the force?
Counting today?
Yes, counting today.
7.5 weeks, sir.
Oh, my God.
Captain, I think you get the picture now. The kid was a little overzealous, that's all. He shot without thinking.
Well, according to this report, you got off a couple of rounds yourself.
Well, I got caught up in the moment.
Yeah.
I'll explain everything when you get here, Bruce. No, no, nothing happened at the office. Just get over here with the money.
Leave the children with the maid and get out of here. All right? Goodbye.
Thank you.
Did you say the maid?
Maid? Yes.
You got a maid just from Beggy?
What difference does it make what a man does? As long as he does it well.
Hey, you can go now, but stay available.
All right, thanks, Captain. We'll do that. Come on, Walt.
Oh, hold it, Walt.
Barney, that's it? That's all that happens?
Well, for the time being, yes.
Warren, this guy here, Whitney...
No, Walt.
He makes more money than we do.
Whoa, Joe!
I said hold it, Walt.
Barney, these two guys are gonna just walk out of here?
Well, no, now we, get on with the official proceedings.
Such as,
formal investigation by the borough commander.
Borough commander.
Hearing by the gun review board. Possibly internal affairs.
And what happens to them?
Well, that's hard to say.
Maybe a suspension, maybe a fine, maybe...
Maybe.
Maybe nothing.
Dietrich.
He asked.
I appreciate that, Dietrich. Now that I know, I can decide on a course of action.
It's already in progress, Harris. We go by the book.
You mean the book written by the man?
Morning, everybody.
What do you want, Levin?
Nothing. Mail, general rounds. Not being assigned up here, I have no way of knowing when I come in at inopportune moments. Shall I leave, sir?
No, just stay right there.
Right. Hey, as long as I understand the rules... Now maybe I can try and play the game.
Harris, you're not thinking clearly now.
Oh, that happens every time I'm shot at, Barney.
Hey, look, if you're really gonna make an issue out of this...
Issue?
You know...
Issue? You cream-colored...
Harris!
Harris, for lunch.
Thank you! I'm leaving. Cover me.
In here, ma'am.
Is this where he is?
Yes, ma'am. Cap Miller, I'm Mrs. Ruth Whitney.
Ma'am?
Claims we're holding her husband.
Ruth!
Sanford? What happened to you? What have you done to him?
What is going on here? Why is my husband dressed like a bum?
Good question, Mrs. Whitney. Mr. Whitney?
Ruth, I've got a confession to make. I'm not a stock analyst anymore, and I haven't been for 3 years.
What?
I've been working as a solicitor.
A lawyer?
A beggar.
Beggar?
Don't say it like that.
How else would you say it?
A beggar. Simple. Nice, soft. A lawyer? A doctor? A beggar? What's so tough?
May I speak to him in private for a moment, please?
Certainly, ma'am. Pleasure.
We'll let you in the cage for a few minutes, Mrs. Whitney.